Guten Tag alle, heute werden wir ein bisschen mehr über die Fälle sprechen. Today we're going to talk again a little bit more about the cases in German. Let's review them. The nominative case, what makes a word nominative? Well, one, it's the subject of a sentence. And two, it comes after a conjugation of the verb sein, such as the present tense conjugations, been, bist, ist, sind, seit, or the past tense conjugations, war, was, wart, or waren. Can also come after the verb werden as well, including the present tense and past tense conjugations. Okay, the accusative case, remember that is the direct object of a sentence, that is what receives the action of the verb. Secondly, it comes after certain accusative prepositions, durch, für, gegen, ohne, and entlang und bis. Entlang is the only one of these prepositions that can occur after the object. Okay, dative case. Remember what makes a word dative? It is the indirect object of a sentence. It is what receives the action of the verb indirectly. Normally, we say to whom or for whom something is given, done, or bought. And then it appears after certain prepositions as well. Aus, außer, bei, mit, nach, seit, von, zu, and then gegenüber. Okay, so now we're gonna try to do a little exercise here, determining what a na case a noun is in. And here I have some sample sentences, and I'm just gonna roll through them with the answers. If you want to work on this on your own, pause the video at this point, and then when you're ready, when you think you have the answers, press play. Okay, los, we're going. We're starting. Ich werde den Hut kaufen. Hut is a direct object, so this is accusative. Du bist eine schöne Frau. Bist is a nominative case. When a noun comes after bist, this is the nominative. In English, we call it the predicate nominative. Was wirst du mit dem Ticket machen? Mit is a dative preposition, so that makes that dative. Das ist für das Auto. So für is an accusative preposition that makes Auto accusative. Wo ist meine Jacke? This is also nominative because it comes after ist. Das Rathaus ist sehr schön. The Rathaus is nominative because it's the subject of the sentence. Wirst du das Kleid anziehen? Will you put on the dress? The dress is the direct object, so this is accusative. Ich werde meinem Freund das Auto leihen. You are loaning the car to your friend. That's an indirect object, so this is dative. Ich lehne mich gegen die Wand. Gegen is an accusative preposition. Ist nicht mein Freund. This is nominative because it comes after ist. Ich liebe meine Deutschklasse. Deutschklasse is accusative. It's what's the direct object. It's receiving the action of the verb. Herr Wallace hat 9 Zehen. So, Zehen are accusative. This is what Herr Wallace has. And then finally, mein Auto ist kaputt. Auto is nominative because it's the subject. Let's try a few more. Again, you want to pause if you don't want the answers or you want to try them on your own. Okay, los geht's. Wo ist der Hund? Hund comes after ist. This is nominative. Sie kocht uns eine Suppe. She's cooking a soup. So the soup is the direct object, accusative. Wir können nach dem Essen gehen. We can go after the meal. Nach is a dative preposition. Ich habe die Katze gesehen. Katze is the direct object, so this is accusative. Ich muss meinen Bleistift spitzen. Bleistift is the direct object, so it's accusative. Das Zimmer ist zu klein. Zimmer is the subject, so it's nominative. Ich kaufe der Lehrerin ein Buch. You're buying the book for the teacher. Teacher is the indirect object, dative. Wann ist die Party? Party is nominative, comes after ist. Wir fahren durch die Stadt. Durch is an accusative preposition, so this is accusative. Kannst du mir das Buch bringen? Buch is what you're bringing. It's the direct object, accusative. Kannst du das Auto waschen? Wash what? The car. It's accusative, direct object. Ist sie deine Schwester? This is going to be nominative, comes after ist. Kam aus dem Zimmer. Aus is a dative preposition, so this is dative. And I don't know if you can quite see it. Hast du meinen Tintenkiller? So this is a direct object, so it's accusative. Okay. Vielen Dank, auf Wiedersehen.